India is dotted with millions of temples and shrines dedicated to various local and pan-Indic deities, saints and sagas. Among the innumerous grand palaces, forts and monuments, temples are undoubtedly the most majestic architectural structures in the country. Indian temples have always been the melting pot of various cultures, art and learning, and hence were built to serve these purposes. The basis of Indian temple architecture lies in the Vastu Shastra and Shilpa Shastra, the ancient Hindu architectural compendiums. Vastu Shastra, one of the 64 kalas, is also considered to be an Upaveda, known as Thapatya Veda. These texts have described the architectural principles and structural guidelines of temples, which are being followed scrupulously across the country for centuries. However, the styles of temples do vary regionally.
Today, Hindu temples are generally classified into two main architectural styles, Nagara and Dravida. The Nagara style of architecture is seen in Western and Northern India, whereas the Dravidian style of architecture is the South Indian style of architecture. So let us start from the Nagara style first. This style has been the predominant architectural style of North Indian temples. This style primarily refers to the architectural text Brihat Samhita, composed by Varahamihira. In Nagara style, the temples are built on an elevated stone platform known as Jagati, with stairs which is constructed by considering several engineering elements as defined in the Vastu Shastra. The temple is generally a single standalone structure divided into several parts. The stairs lead us to the foremost part, which is called Ardha Mandapa. This is the porch where the guardian deities of the temple are housed.
Ardha Mandapa is followed by Mandapa, which is the large hall of the temple. Mandapas are more spacious than the Ardha Mandapas. Mandapa further leads us to the Mahamandapa, a great hall which is much larger than the Mandapa and is largest part of the temple. Pillars and walls of the Mahamandapa and Mandapa are extensively carved and decorated with several historical and mythological characters and stories related to the deity housed in that particular temple. Mahamandapas are built in such a way so that they can accommodate a considerable number of devotees, as several cultural and religious events take place here. The acoustics of structure is generally taken into consideration while constructing mandapas and mahamandapas. Both have separate shikharas or spires above them, which assist in amplification and projection of sound.
Mahamandapa is followed by a small horizontal passage which opens on two sides and is a part of Pradakshina Marga or the path of circumambulation. The Sanctum Sanctorum or the Garbhagriha is located at the end of the temple and is always directly below the highest spire or shikhar of the temple. This highest shikhar symbolizes the connection of the presiding deity with its universal form and is seen as the most energetically significant place in the temple. The conical nose of the shikhar is always pinnacled with kalasha, that is, a metallic pot with a narrow opening, which may boast a flag sometimes. Nagar style has got four major sub-styles of building shikharas: Latina, Vallabhi, Hamsana and Shekhari. Latina, also known as Rekha Prasad, is the most common style, distinguishable by its symmetrically slabbed curved shikharas. Shekhari, on the other hand, has more sharp-edged conical shikharas.
Now let's have a look at the Dravidian architectural style. Dravidian architectural style is based on various texts like Mayamata, Devalaya Lakshana, Kamikagama, Manasara Shilpa and many other agamas and sutras. Most of the Dravidian temples do not have Jagati or the raised surface and are built on plain ground. However, some have their sanctorium built on a strong platform called Adhishthan. There are various types in Adhishthan, each having its unique components and composition styles. Sometimes, in order to provide a better elevation to the sanctum, the Adhishthana itself is built on the top of another additional basement called Upapitha or supplementary basement. Unlike Nagara temples, these temples are generally surrounded by walls like a fortress with multiple entrances into the temple premises. The entrance gateways are towered by eye-catching colossal gopurams which connect one area of the temple to another.
Gopurams are contemporary of the Nagara Shikharas. Gopuras are always built on the doorways or gates of the palisades surrounding the sanctum. They are richly decorated and sculptured with the statues of various deities and depict their tales. The gopurams are built in multiple stories called talas. The topmost tala is always the narrowest, with the size increasing downwards. The first and lowermost tala, just above the gateway, is the widest and largest. The topmost gopura has several numbers of kalashas, with the largest one being at the center. The size of the gopurams also goes on decreasing with the gateways of the inner wall enclosures, with the outermost enclosure having the tallest gopurams. The main temple layout is common in both Nagara and Dravid style, consisting of Ardha Mandapa, Mandapa and Garbhagriha. The Ardha Mandapa is followed by the Maha Mandapa, which is connected to a passage called Antaral, leading to Garbhagriha. A pyramidal structure known as Vimana is built directly above the Garbhagriha. Vimanas are quite smaller in size as compared to the surrounding towering gopurams and are usually plated in gold. The sanctum is often called as Shri Vimana or Vimana Nilayam.
The Mandapa and Garbhagriha usually have a wide open space in front known as Ayatan. Many of the temple processions and festive ceremonial rites are performed in these ayatans. Dravidian temples usually have a tank called the Pushkarini, which is used for sacred rites and the convenience of the priests. Devotees aren't allowed to enter into these tanks as they are reserved to be used by the priest for ritualistic purposes. There are several other styles of temple architecture, like Vesara, which can be seen as the fusion Dravid and Nagara, or regionally evolved styles like that of Kerala and Bangar. But these remain as a topic for the upcoming video. Stay tuned and stay educated. And last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigation of the truth. Shubhaste Panthana Santu. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.